And now that I think about it, poise not being in Dark Souls 3 is a really, really big problem. Like, it's a bigger problem than I thought. Because it's made the meta really garbage. All the high-level players use no armor with no poise, because poise doesn't exist, so you don't need it. And either ultra great swords or rapiers. And that's what everyone uses in PvP at max level. And there's only one armor set in the entire game that even has special effects. Like, the Crown of Dusk is in the game, and that increases spell casting. But that's about it. So, I don't know, it's just weird. Alright, let's... I want to go back to Firelink Shrine and check up on something really quick. But, I know what armor I'm going to be using to kind of show you my point. Because there's only one armor set, I think, that's even, like, hands down the best armor set to use in the game for PvP. There really isn't any equivalent for PvE. As far as I know. Well, oh, hang on, my laptop's on. See ye in good health. What needs smithing? Let me see if, there we go. Alright. I thought I had one more Estus shard. And I can't upgrade my Uchigatana again yet, so we'll hold on to that. Is Hawkwood here? Hawk. What? Sorry, that was probably gross. Whenever I say Hawkwood, I feel like I need to hawk a loogie. So I might just start calling him Hawkwood. That'd be super disgusting. No, he's not here. He should be here. What the hell? I need to look that up really quick. Hang on. Because he's supposed to spawn there for me. No, that's not Hawkwood. That's the other guy. I'm stupid. Alright, let me look up NPCs. It's the other dude. What's his name? Leonhard. There we go. Leonhard's got something for me. After obtaining one Pale Tongue. And lighting Cliff's underside bonfire, defeating... Okay, got it. I know what I gotta do. Okay, cool. I'm glad I looked that up, because I would have been really confused. That's a weird... For some reason, I don't understand why that boss spawns off of that, but... whatever. So let's go to... where we just were. Come on, load faster. All right. There's the undead settlement. That's where we're going. We raise our banner to the sky. It's nice seeing these guys again. I'm kind of surprised, I don't think they actually show up again in the game. They just kind of do this for you, and it's like, hey, thanks, buddies. All right, bye. And that's the last we see of them. Yep. Kind of like, well, that was awesome. That reminds me of Anne Orlando and all that stuff. Yay, and can't wait to see more of them. As far as I know, that's the only ones that exist in this game. I know. It's, ugh. It's, ugh. Alright. So we're going to head down here, and one of the key things we got to do for our build is going to be down here. We're going to take a left. Going to go over this way. And we gotta kill these dogs. I suppose we don't have to kill the dogs, but I'd rather kill the dogs as opposed to not kill the dogs. Look at all these dead pilgrims. Poor bastards.
Please, grant me death. Undo my shackles.
Mm.
Oh, then it's true. A champion of Ash, as I live and breathe. To be in your presence is a great honor. I am Njol of Londor, a pilgrim, as you can see, only somehow I failed to die as was ordained. Well, perhaps my calling lies elsewhere. Say, champion of Ash, how does the idea of taking me into your service strike you? I was once a sorcerer. Surely I can be of use.
Nah.
Oh, I am honored, truly. I should be dead, yet you have granted me purpose anew. I, Yol of Londor, do solemnly swear myself to you.
Okay, cool, bye, see you later. So he's a cool guy. He's going to sell sorceries for us that we're not really going to make too much use of. Yeah. But we'll see more of him later. At first, he seems like the sorcery guy, and he's just kind of like doing the sorcery thing for us. But that is totally not his only role. Especially when you do find an actual sorcery guy later. And you're just like, what? If that's the sorcery guy, who's this guy? Oh. Spooky scary. Not really. Alright. Alright, Muffin Button. Fuck you. Alright, what we got here? We got a bonfire. We're gonna light the bonfire. I'm going to take a rest here for a second. Let's see if we can get a little bit of help to take us through this zone. I just see one yellow sign pop up. If I don't see any more, I'm probably going to go ahead and bail and get on the road. Oh, here we go. Coda? Is this our friend for today? We only really need one. Only one. Secret ahead. That leads to death! And you're a creeper! He almost got me. He almost knocked me right off the thing. Aw. That was another guy I could have summoned. There are more people! More friends! Sweet. Okay, that's the maximum number of friends we can summon. Hi! Oh, all the controls swapped back. Hi. Ah! I was trying to say hello, you rude person. Are you coming with me, or are you like... Alright, well, Coda is apparently having brain trouble, so let's just go. Okay, never mind. They're both good. Dark Spirit Cole! Oh no, not a dark spank. Oh my god, he's right here. Well, that's a gang spank. Hey. Hey. No. He's gonna be fine just dealing with those guys. I got other stuff to do. You guys play with the dark spirit. You can kill him if you want. I don't really care. Is there a way to get outside up here? No? Alright. Hey! Coda, dude, go help your friend. You asshole. What the hell's wrong with my freaking other phantom just leaving his buddy to die? That's lame. I mean, lame and kind of cool because then we're not just completely murdering the shit out of this phantom. Wow. This phantom's a badass. He killed both of my summons. Wow. I'm impressed. Is he using the freaking dark sword? He is. Wow. Ugh. Ah! Damn you, poise! I hate poise. I hate the poise in this game. Sucks. All you have to do is poke someone. My two phantoms were completely useless, Jesus. They were just like, hey, I'm gonna help you kill other things that are not at all the things you need to be killing. Couple of assholes. I can do better than that, damn. I'll put down my sign. Alright. Okay. Those two phantoms really were really huge wieners. Like, wonder if they were trolling me on purpose. I deliberately didn't gang up on that Dark Phantom. They're just kind of like, we suck. We're not gonna help or work together in any shape or form. Ah, god damn it! Get off my head! Fuck. Fuck. Oh. Hey, a blue sentinel spawn. That's nice. And a little bit weird. Did I get... But I'm not embered, so... What the fuck? What the fuck? I'm so confused. He just... And then he... Why? What the hell? Just freaking just shows up and leaves? I have no idea. I am flabbergasted. Maybe he was trying to get summoned in and then like... But no, even that doesn't make sense. Okay, my brain hurts. Alright, now that we're not embered, I can safely do this other thing I wanted to do. We're gonna grab that, that's for Grey Rat, and we're gonna head over this way. Because if dark spirits were invading me, this part would be really annoying. Okay. All right. First thing we're going to do, we need to go down through here. And we got to unlock a shortcut. Shortcut should be right. Oh. No, fuck you. Eyeballs. That was a little spooky. Alright. So we got that unlocked. I'm gonna take a swig. Let's head up this way. Okie dokie. Eh. People. Alright. I think there might be one item down here. Maybe. Item? No? Okay. Lame! Stop throwing shit at me. Got that. Okay. We're good. I'm gonna drink up. And you find this guy over here. It's got this little cage thing. And I think we can go past him. See, he doesn't even attack you. He just kind of ignores you. We can chop that down for maybe later. I think later, maybe. Yeah, that's where Egon of Kareem is. Okay. So, I might remember that this is here. I think I can fall down there safely without killing myself. But yeah, you go over to this guy and examine his little cage thing, and it looks interesting. And Asara's all like, huh, that looks like something I can get in. And the guy's like, hey, buddy, you want to go for a ride? And Asara's just like, adventure time. So you randomly get in this cage for whatever reason, and off to the Coca-Cola plant you go. About the weirdest way to enter a covenant I've encountered in my playthroughs of Dark Souls games. But hey, that's fine. Who's that man over there? Who's that man in the secret cave place we've suddenly found ourselves in? Ooh, this place looks crazy. War God wooden shield.
Well, what's up? This pit is for hollows, not for the likes of you, sane folk. Or perhaps you are a hollow, posing as otherwise?
Yep.
Yes. Then we are just fine. It's important to know who you are. But we'll all be mad soon enough. And should you be undead, well, all the more so. Beware. The shackles of the gods are fragile. You might need this. Etch it on your heart if you feel your sanity slipping.
Mound makers!
Come here to pile up your victims, for that will form your anchor. You'll see when you go mad. They'll be your family.
Okay.
You go. Take my...
So he's telling us to bail now that we've accessed this place. But anyway, this is the Mound Makers Covenant, where you can offer vertebra shackles. And it's going to be the covenant we use for PvP. to invade people. So we're going to pledge ourselves to the mound-making covenant, and we are going to make some mounds, and that's going to be our game. So I'm going to homeward bone back to the shrine bonfire and see if I can level up once. I've got a good amount of souls. I might be able to go up at least once. And then once we get back, I'm going to drop my summon sign again, and I'm going to see who wants to have a mound maker help them through this zone. It's kind of funny. Very well, then take none. Like, summons are so few and far between that you kind of just got to take what you get. So, if you see a mound maker, it's just like, this guy might be a dick and might try to kill me, but at the same time, I really need help, so... It's kind of fun, the dynamic it puts off. So, we're going to keep jacking up all three of those stats. Vigor, Endurance, and Luck. I'm not sure if I need more dex later, but for now I think we're good. Do I have any undead bone shards? Yeah, awesome. I had a feeling I had at least one of those. And we're going to travel back to the undead settlement again. Actually, no, I forgot to do something. I gotta go back, I'm sorry. I keep forgetting things. There's a lot to do in the Undead Settlement. This place is very, it's very rich. We're going to explore the entirety of this, area before we move on to the next one. But, I'm going to head back to the shrine. There is one important thing I need to do while we're back there. Or actually, technically two. Because I got the thing I need to interact with Grey Rat. So, wow, I just wasn't thinking. I'm sorry. Alright. Whoop!
Oh, hello, you're back. And in one piece. Whatever trinket you need, speak up. Just don't ask me where I got them. Heavens, she was already dead. Thank you. I'm not surprised, though. Almost a relief, really. You can keep the ring. As... well... a little trinket of thanks, I suppose.
Alright. Does that have anything you need? No, not really. We can sell stuff to him. There's that pale tongue we need to hold on to. Alright. Bye, Grey Rat! We'll come back and talk to you more later.
Oh, our champion of Ash. Welcome home. This pilgrim, with a debt in death, hardly deserves to behold this divine flame. And I never would have, had you not taken me into your service. I thank you dearly for this, and assure you of my leal service.
Okay, buddy.
Then shall we begin?
You're gonna draw up my true strength.
Sign. Let your true strength shine.
Alright, so this adds a weird mechanic to the game. Basically, we're gonna start getting points to level, we're gonna start getting free levels from our buddy here.
Be safe.
And it's gonna be nice for us, but it's gonna make something weird happen. And it's not showing up on my character sheet just yet, so I won't spoil it for those of you who are unaware. So we're just gonna chill. Hey, Hawkwood's back.
Yet to give in, eh? Good. The firekeeper must be twitching with delight. What do you really know about these Lords of Cinder, these supposed legends? Let's take Aldrich for one, a right and proper cleric, only he developed a habit of devouring men. He ate so that he bloated like a drowned pig, then softened into sludge. So they stuck him in the Cathedral of the Deep, and they made him a Lord of Cinder, not for virtue, but for might. Such as a lord, I suppose. But here I ask, do we have a sodding chance?
Yes! Okay. Let's go back where we were. We're going to go down that path again, just the same way, and I think I might just book it. I might just run the whole thing and not kill any mobs, because we need to get to another bonfire, and then from that other bonfire, we need to book it to another place that will be handy to us for multiple reasons. So I'm just going to do a lot of running here. I'm not going to waste any time. And let's see if we can actually run this whole... No, we can't because of this guy. Damn, God fucking, you piece of shit. Fuck off. Okay. Whoop. No, leave me alone. Leave me alone. I don't like you. Alright, we're gonna bail this way. I'm gonna take a quick drink. And then we're gonna continue to bail, like so. We're gonna run all the way through here. I don't need you, but I do need to go down here, where our two friends are at. And I'm just gonna move on past them, take a quick swig, light this bonfire. I think we'll take 5 at it. And then get back on the road. We are on a mission. We got shit to do, guys. Alright. Worker trousers, that's fine. Can I fall down there? Oh god, there's stuff. There's a lot of stuff. Yeah, that looks like it could possibly kill me, so... I've only got 1,000 souls, fuck it. Ooh, shit! Woohoo! Woohoo! Fuck y'all! Get fucked on! Woohoo! What you gonna do? What you gonna do? I'm gonna drink, and I'm gonna get through here, and I've got invincibility frames when I'm opening doors because it's Dark Souls 3. Haha! Fuck you! Fuck you! And here we go. Oh, God! Hey! I don't want you to go that far. He seems to have made a friend up there, and that's halting his advance. Oh, fuck God. Sorry, I did not mean to actually say fuck God. That was a combination of two things. Ah! You know what's really annoying? Is how hard it is to break enemy poise when we don't have any. I think that's the most annoying thing about Dark Souls 3 for me. Like, they went through all the trouble of being like, oh, you, player poise isn't a thing in the game. Oh, it's a feature. We disabled it as a feature. Ha ha ha. Yeah. When it comes to stuff like this, and... God. I hate to complain just this much, but it really is putting a damper on the gameplay. And I'm hoping the set I'm going to use is going to reinforce that.
Oh. Pardon me, I was absorbed in thought. I am Siegvert of Katarina. To be honest, I'm in a bit of a pickle. Have you ever walked near a white birch only to be struck by a great arrow? Well, if I'm not mistaken, they come from this tower. Whoever it is, I'm sure I can talk some sense into them. But I have to find a way up, and that's just the trouble. This lift only goes down, you see, and... Well, that doesn't get me anywhere.
Let's see if we can help him out. We're going to head on down here. There's something down here I really don't want to fight, but... fighting it will be actually kind of nice for us. So I'm going to fight it, even though I don't want to. I just got to be careful when I fight it. Alright, come on. Come on, you dick. Yep. It's a miniature version of the first boss. Only slightly more annoying and more unpredictable, and he builds up frostbite like twice as fast as the last boss, and he doesn't really give you a break between his attacks, and he just kind of goes crazy. Like, look at this guy. Like, fuck off, seriously. Ah! God damn it! If I can, like, fight him without getting hit, it's not a problem. But the second I get touched, he's just like, dicka-dicka-dicka-dicka.
Fuck you, ha ha ha. I'm an asshole and I keep hitting you no matter what.
I really need, like, at least one ultra great sword for guys like this, where I can break their poise really easy. What the hell? Did I look the wrong way? Oh, yeah, I did. I went the wrong way. Let's go this way. So, let's fight that guy again. This time, I'll try to be a little bit more concentrating. Watching my stamina to make sure I'm not running out of runny. Oh, this elevator takes us up now. That's weird. Only not weird. I know exactly why it's doing that. While we're up here, I might as well go ahead and do this.
Who are you?
I am a friend.
I help. Anytime.
Yay.
I help.
So the giant's our friend now. As unexpected as that might have been. And just as easy as that, the giant will actually stop shooting at us. Otherwise, he would have shot at us had we continued. He's scripted to fire at you whenever you're near those white birches. But after doing that, he won't shoot at us anymore. He'll be a cool guy. Alright. Let me see if I can fight this thing a little bit more. Not stupidly. It just attacks so fast. If it touches you, it breaks your poise and just ugh. You never get a chance to recover against these things. Hang on. Grab my bloodstain. I I guess I can get on the other side of a column and it makes it a little better, but... Fuck! Come on. Ugh! God, you're annoying. Piss off. Let me heal, thank you. Let me heal again, thank you. Okay, that was good. Ugh! Break poise! Thank you. God! That Irithyll straight sword's what I wanted. For now, we're gonna use that, because we're coming up on something that is weak against it. Does a lot less damage, but that frostbite effect is going to be really cool here in a second. No pun intended. Also, I need to go through this door. I should have done that earlier, but I wasn't braining. All right. Actually, let me look at this thing. What's the stats? DD? Okay. Yeah. It's pretty good. Pretty good little weapon here. It even has a cool, like, effect on it. It's all frosty and whatnot. Okay. Let's head back up. The hell just died. Enemies just randomly die. Whoop!
Ah! Oh! Don't disappear like that. You had me downright worried. But thanks to you, an epiphany has struck me square in the head. I've unraveled the riddle of this inscrutable lift. On some days, I begin to doubt myself. I went up the tower, so I thought, then somehow ended up here. I'm not exactly sure what happened. Anyhow, do you see that? That humongous beast? I'm no coward, and I've a steady hand, but that thing makes my skin crawl. How now? Think twice before you go down that road. I could try talking some sense into him. No, I think not. He's far too overheated. I've got to use my head and think.
I love that guy. Oh my god. All right, well, let's go attack the fire demon and get absolutely owned.
No, you should have waited.
Oh god, it's pissed. Help me. Help me.
No.
The
Knights of Katarina, fight by your side.
Here he goes. What a beast. Ow! Oh god! Back up. Ah! Ooh! Take threat! Oh no! Ah! Damn it! I've never had him completely turn around on me before. Sigward, what the hell? What happened to your awesome tanking skills, bro? Sigward usually keeps his attention really good, but he was just kind of like sitting back and watching me work. It was unexpected. This guy's an asshole. Well, I thought that was going to go better than it did, but apparently not. Okay, I need to pull this lift. We'll get back up there and try it again. As long as Sigurd didn't die, I think we can do this as many times as we want. This is the first time this thing's actually killed me. Technically, it didn't kill me. My own stupidity killed me. Ugh. We might take a detour. I want to get a shield from the next zone. We're really close to the next zone. I might just walk down there and grab it. Oh, shit! God damn it. I thought the entire side was encircled. Not just that one. God damn it. I'm having a bad day suddenly. I might be distracted or something. My brain's not working. You know what? My thought about going to get that shield is distracting me. I'm gonna go just run and grab that shield. Fuck it. I'm just gonna ignore everything and go get that shield, because I really want it right now. For no real great reason other than I just want it. So, we're gonna fuck it. We're gonna run past all this shit, and I wanna go get that goddamn shield I want. Excuse me. Bye. All right. Light this bonfire. Take a quick break. Let's talk to these people while we're here.
Oh, hello. How do you do? I am Anri of Astora, unkindled like you. This is Horace, a friend and traveling companion. Are you too in search of the Lords of Cinder? We are well along the road of sacrifices. Below us is the Crucifixion Woods. Beyond the flooded woods lies Farron Keep, home of the Undead Legion. Further yet is the Cathedral of the Deep. We seek the cathedral, home of the grim Aldrich. We may go our separate ways now, but we are both seekers of lords. The next time we cross paths, one may find the other in a time of need. May the flames guide your way. Oh, yes, he's not very talkative, but don't think ill of him. He's an upstanding, kind-hearted knight, a fine partner for this grueling journey. Without his help, I would have cursed this onerous duty long ago.
Hi, Horace. Man of plenty words. All right. Okay. I'm only here in the swamp to get one thing, and then once we grab it, I'm gonna get the fuck out of here, and we're gonna go... Blah, 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 fuck you. We're gonna go do other shit. Go back and help that guy that we met earlier. I think I see it. I think that's it right there. Shield, 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 shield. Please be the shield. Please be the shield. I don't want it to be anything else. Yes! Hell yeah! Alright. There's a bonfire around here. We're gonna stop and rest at that, and then we're gonna teleport back. Fuck off, dogs! Alright. Light that bonfire. We're gonna teleport back to the Road of Sacrifices. I just skipped a lot of shit. We will be exploring it later, don't worry. I just wanted more freaking stamina, because not having it is making me mad. That's why I beelined on this adventure in the first place. I want to get all my stam regen items rolling. Without all that stam regen, I just feel bad. I feel, like, way more slow than I should be. Okay. So we're going to grab the Grass Crest Shield. And I don't need to explain the Grass Crest Shield. You guys know about the Grass Crest Shield. It is the best shield ever. As far as medium shields go. If you want to use a great shield, obviously that, or that Havel's and Yorm's and whatever else is way better, but for being just a general use shield, let me see the stats on it, actually. It'll block 90% of physical attacks, 43% of magic attacks, and about 33% about everything else. It's a pretty reliable shield as far as that's concerned. I mean, that's not super great stats, but what really, really does it is slightly speeding stamina recovery. Hell yeah! With this shield and one of the rings we're going to be picking up very shortly, we will be good to go. And we won't really have the problems I've been having anymore. Okay, that... Alright, it's the left side, not the right, so... Alright, round two. What does he actually say to you?
Okay, it doesn't even register, got it.
Okay, let's do this again with less retard. Oh, Siegmeyer, no! Leave my friend alone! Ow! Fuck you!
No! You should have waited! Well, it's too late now. I, Siegward of the Knights of Katarina, fight by your side!
Fire Gem! Got a ton of souls!
That was quite a performance. But you mustn't get in over your head. We Unkindled must put our duties first. But, for the moment, we've a toast to make. To your valor, my sword, and our victory together. Long may the sun shine. Well, I'm going to have myself a little nap. The only thing to do, really, after a nice toast.
Good shit. Alright, that's the first part of Sigurd's side quest done. We're going to switch back to the Fire Uchi Katana, and we're going to head through here. There's a lot of not much in this place. This is like a little side area, I guess. It's kind of like the Sigurd's quest was sort of just kind of placed here, and then the entire little experience was built around it. So I'm just gonna roll through here and make sure I didn't forget anything. It's just that one fire demon, I'm pretty sure, but don't see much else. Pale Tongue. Hey, zombie. Alright. Where the hell... Okay. Alright. I think that's everything we can get from out there. Red Bug Pellet. You know, I'm curious. Can I put down... No, I can't put down my white sign soapstone in this place for some reason. Woo-wee! Ow! God! Fuck your poise! Shit. Ah! Stop! God, that's annoying. Alright, nobody there. Everyone's just kind of watching the world burn. Are these people turning into trees? Apparently so. Okay. Is this a mimic? No. Uh-oh, ambush. Ambush. I can just kind of poke all of them. I think I can one-shot them with pokes. I started off with the warrior class in this game. And I'm going to be running a dex and luck build. Oh. Hi, bitches. Ah! Let's not get too crazy. Come on. Ah! Fuck! And I'm stuck in a fucking corner. Okay, never mind. Whew! Alright, I'm gonna back up. Got a little bit of blood loss going. I'm not a fan of that. Eh. Yep. Only problem with using Grass Crest now is I no longer have 100% physical block reduction. No, don't hug me. No hugs allowed. Stab in your butt. Stab in your butt. There we go. I don't think there's anything else that's annoying in here. Let's head around the side. Anything over here I can grab? Nope. Up on the roof. Might be something up on the roof. Oh, there's this. Flynn's Ring. Flynn's Ring increases your attack if you have really, really low equipment, which isn't really useful unless you are a... Spoilers. I found use for it as a spoilers in spoilers, so I'll talk about it when I get to spoilers. Alright. I think that's it for up there. You can go down here. Walk around the left side of this. And get a homeward bone. Oh, it's the right side, not the left side. Derp. Let's have a quick drink. Okay, I want to make sure I jump this right. Ah! Oof. Alright, we made it in one piece. We got the Mira set. And then the Chloranthi Ring! Chloranthi Ring! Chloranthi Ring. Yep, that's another ring that doesn't really, reduces damage for backstab. Shit, I should have been wearing that. That's another ring that doesn't really have much effect on us. I'm gonna go ahead and take all this armor off, and I'm gonna replace it with... something else. Let's try the Thrall Hood. Do we have the entire mirror set? No, we don't. We just have part of it. mirror gloves, and mirror trousers. And that's going to make our weight a little bit better. We look a little ridiculous for now, but that's fine. Okay. I want to do a little bit of looking around down here. I think we're done with this part, though. Yep, we're done. Alright, cool. Hop down. Roll over here. We're back to this door. I think can we open this? No, we can't. It doesn't open from this side. Alright, cool. Let's homeward bone, actually. If I can get to it. Bonfire last rested at. Yep. Oh, boy. So I've got to think of the best way to kind of explore the rest of this place. I might want to go ahead and head back. Yeah, I want to head back to Firelink Shrine. Now that I've unlocked that one bonfire, I should have just teleported straight to Firelink Shrine, but I wasn't thinking. And we're going to get the item from, what's his face that's really awesome? Oh, hey, lady.
You're an unkindled, aren't you? I am Cirrus of the Sunless Realms, former servant of the divinity. Duties we each bear, but one's duty is a solitary affair. I doubt we've much to gain from fraternization. Blessing of the moon upon your journey. I doubt we've much left.
Wow, what a freaking bitch. Jeez. I doubt we have much to gain from talking to one another, so let's not do that. Okay. Can I level up on the fire keeper?
Very well, then take me.
I think I can. Nope, I'm a little bit off.
Well, Ashen One.
That's what I've got you for, though.
Ashen.
That should be just enough.
Very well, then take
me. It is awesome. Let's crank that luck stat up.
Farewell.
Let's see if we can level up off of, what's his face? Yol of Londor.
I then shall bear.
Awesome. Okay, how many times can I level up? Just one? Alright, cool. Yay! Levels! Good. Do we have any Titanite? We got a ton of Titanite chunks, of course, but... I really want to get a deep gem, and eventually I think I'm going to get a deep gem, and I'm going to swap out my Fire Uchi Katana for a deep Uchi Katana that does dark damage.
She was already dead.
Oh, he's depressed. Aww. I'm sorry.
Heavens.
I feel bad now. Poor guy. Okay. Let me think. What do we need to do now? Oh, shit! We need to backtrack and just go back to the start of the zone. We need to go to, like... Oh, wait. I forgot the entire reason I came back here. Fuck. I keep getting distracted. At least I think it was the entire reason I came here. Is he back? Alright, cool. He's back. Cool.
Well... Hasn't it been some time? I'm Leonard, the Ringfinger. Remember me? I slipped you those red eyes some time ago. You're making quite an effort of it, so I thought you might like to know. If you yearn for a proper red eye orb, one that is uncracked,
Then kill the Dark Wraith, survivor of the land swallowed by darkness. He has been a prisoner for many ages in the deepest cell in all Lothric. I can see it in your eyes. If you didn't invade, didn't pillage, whatever would you do?
Cry, probably. Okay, so he wants us to go kill the Dark Wraith, and if we kill the Dark Wraith, we get a proper red eye orb. Infinitely useful for invading people. So let's go to where that is. It's going to be Tower on the Wall. Right here. Okay, go down the stairs. Pop this guy. Pop this guy. Ow, 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 ow. Maybe we're not gonna pop him. Maybe he's gonna pop me. Ah, goddammit. I don't think we need to kill this guy, just want to get him out of the way. Okay, let's head through this cell. And go down. We have such a happy face with our new mask, I like it. I think I might just keep it. Alright. Hi, Dark Wraith! You're not near as intimidating as the game would have you believe you are. Except for having poise, which is slightly intimidating. Well, I guess I can just poke you to death. Ah, goddammit! Oh, shit! No, he comboed me! No! Damn you! Stop. It's not going well. Fuck. Backstab, yes! Woo! I don't know how he missed me with that. That was pretty right on. Two-hander. Fuck! Ah, no! Drink. You and your dark sword. Fuck off. And fuck off! Yeah. There we go. Red eye orb! Full red eye invasions. We're gonna swap that out on our bar. That's gonna be a good common use invading item. Hell, I might just use it right now. Luckily, in this game, you can invade people without being embered. That's super freaking useful. I wonder if it'll actually screw up my, Yeah, I might not find a world to invade here. Everyone at this point's usually gone somewhere else. Oh, well. Alright, let's just bail back to the undead settlement, then. Okay. We're a bit buffer than we were last time we were here. I'm going to throw my summon sign down again. Except now my summon sign is nice and purple. So everyone's going to be like, I don't know about this guy. But I'm going to help people. I'll help people. That'll be nice. They'll just have to deal with the possibility that I could be evil. It'll make for interesting shenanigans. If I get tired of being a mound maker, I'm going to switch to my other covenant, though. I've got two covenants that I'm going to use with this build. And only two covenants that I want to use with this build. And that's going to be mound makers for PvP and another one that we're about to pick up very soon. Well, come on out. Wah. Okay. All right. Let's just carefully make our way through here. Wah. I think we can get around here without drawing too much flak. What the hell? I thought that would have exploded. Fuck you. Okay, we pissed off the horde now. They should all start coming after me. I'm gonna back up. Whoop! Sword in your butt! And sword in your butt! Evangelist trousers, oh, that's nice. We got a cool item from that. No! No praying. It's a prayer-free zone. Eh. Take a swig. Get away. Fuck off. Charcoal pine resin, okay. That's the shard, okay. Good stuff, good stuff, good stuff, good stuff, good stuff, good stuff. So far. Whoop. Man, it'll be super nice when I get my faster weapon going. This katana is just like slightly too slow, and most of these monsters are able to attack me back a little too easily. Eh! Alright. Anything in here? Yeah, there's stuff in here. Give me a second. I want to explore around it first. Oh, pile of bodies in a corner. Oh, that's lovely. That's some good real estate value. You guys couldn't afford to just clean up a little bit? Are you that crazy and undead and weird that you need to litter your bodies about everywhere? Okay. Titanite shard. Good, 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 good. That might be another upgrade for us. I think I've got three, so four. That should do it. Eh! Dead bodies, dead bodies. Alright, fall down here. Run over here. Warrior of Sunlight! Hooray! We have that covenant now. And that will be the covenant I end up switching to if I'm not feeling like dicking with people. Because I feel like it's brighter and people are just like, oh, it's a Sunbro! I want to summon the Sunbro! And everyone, like, just goes crazy for Sunbros. I don't really get anything from that covenant that I really need, but it's better than just not picking it, if you know what I mean. Oh, shit. Oh, here we go. Fuck! Fuck! Alright. Finding reasons to calm down now. I think we're through about the rough of it. What treasure's up here? Treasure? Treasure over here? Yes. Yay. Treasure good. Treasure make me happy. Okay. Let's go this way. Oh god. Shooting dark magic at me. Is there anything in here I need? I don't think there's anything in here I need. Other than a crazy pile of hats just fell out of the ceiling. Ow! Ow! Oh, that's blood magic. She's shooting blood magic at me. At least I assume it's a she. The whip! Whippy good. Is there another friend? No. Excuse me? Hmm? Ooh. When I get to this next bonfire, I'm gonna need to take a quick break. Actually, no. I can kill the next boss before I take that quick break. At least I think so. We're not really all that far away from it. Can I jump attack you? You've put yourself in a really wonderful position for me to just jump attack you. Unless you've moved. Did you move? Where'd you move to? Hello? Hello? Yes! Fuck you. Whack! Come, come! Wow. That was a complete miss. That was amazing. I was about to Kamehame it, and the invincibility frames just were like, nope, she's still on the ground, you're not allowed to attack. As per the rules of engagement passed down from Dark Souls to Dark Souls. No, little lizard buddy! No! No, don't leave! Fuck. He left. I'm sad. Little lizard buddy. Alright. Welp. That's a bunch of butts. Okay. Let's see if we can get our ember back. I'm gonna go rest at this bonfire right here. And we're gonna sit down for just a sec. We could go plug that Estus shard in and probably level up off of it, but... Or, sorry. Use that for something, but... Let's invade someone. I should be able to invade someone here. It shouldn't be too hard. Soul level should match up. And I look significantly terrifying with my crazy wonky hat. I should be able to invade. Come on. Invade. Good, yes. Oh crap, I forgot to grab that thing. It's not gonna let me invade. It's gonna wait. At least I think that's what's happening. It's taking a bit long. Hello? Hello? I don't have Cross Realm turned off, do I? What are my network settings here? Unrestricted, voice chat, restricted, player name display, character name, play online. Alright. Yeah, I do like to turn voice chat off. I just think that it's silly unless I'm playing with other people that I want to talk on voice with. Alright, there's no other worlds, I guess. Alright. Well, in that case, I'm going to take a quick break, and I will be right back. Stream just 1 second. It'll be like 2 minutes. So check back in 2 minutes. I just got to pee. Ugh. You know, now that I've thought about it, I think I know what's causing some of the problem. I'm so over-leveled because of killing that other thing that I bet it's causing a weird issue. So I'm going to throw my summon sign. Actually, hang on, let me switch covenants so people don't think I'm an asshole. And... Alright, I'll engage in jolly cooperation. The boss is just, like, right up here, so... It's not that far off. Yep, like I thought. No one likes purple guys. Nobody. Host of Ember's Pork Chop, alright. You coming? What the hell? Your friend up here is scared, alright. Whack. I am curious to see if Mr. Porkchop here is, if he's gone around and made friends with the giant yet or not. I guess we'll see shortly. That would be a no. That would be a negatory on that. Take a quick sip. No giant friends today. All right. Actually, he seems to have absolutely no idea what the hell he's doing. Oh my god! Are you serious? Wow. That was kind of pathetic. Man. You can't, like, survive for 2 seconds against the freaking arrow guy. The hell is wrong with you? Well, I guess I'll throw down my summon sign again. You know what? I've already got some embers. I'm just going to blow an ember. Because I want to get... There we go. I wanted to get that guy to invade. I knew there was a mad spirit up here that wanted to play, so... Alright, buddy. I think this is a repeat invader. He comes at you every now and then. You can tell they're NPCs because they don't stagger on every single hit. Well, that move actually gave him a little extra poise, so I don't know if that's totally true. Are you... Oh. Wow. You're something special there. I can just use your warmth. Heals me too, buddy. What? You're the one that spawned it. Don't look at me like that. You're the one that sucks at parrying. What? That guy was way easier than I remember him being. Vertebra shackle, yay! Vertebra shackle for me. Okay. Alright, cool. Well, we got some souls. I'm not too worried about losing them, though. Fuck you, yeah. We have orbital bombardment on our side. Keep shooting, buddy. Keep shooting. Oh god, that's so fun to watch. Oh, I get shat on. Oh, that's good. That's so good. Alright. Hunted bone shard. Good, 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 good stuff. Okay, let's keep exploring this graveyard. Wow. I didn't kill him in one hit with a backstab. It's like a super crazy pumped up greatsword wielding whatever the hell that thing is. Stalker? I'm wearing their hat. I don't remember their name. Okay. Mortician's Ashes is a very important item. We're going to hold on to that for now, though. Okay. I don't think there's anything else in here. I think we can just run on to the boss now. So let's go ahead and do that. Just F off to where the boss is. Hey! Are you... Mr. Dancy Dance? He didn't even drop anything. Okay, up here. I think we can jump onto that little railing. Thank you. Great scythe. May not be the best scythe, but it is definitely the great scythe. Run through here. Alright. There's a lot of summon signs for this boss. You know what? I'm going to go ahead and... Do I have my dried finger? No, I think I forgot to buy it. Damn. I was going to say I was just going to summon like 3 people for this fight. A lot of people like to do this fight for summons because he's just so easy to kill. And I like to summon people more or less just to help them get embers back. This is a really easy boss. It's just got adds. Actually, you know, all the bosses in this game are pretty not bad until about... I think the last 3. The last 3 bosses in this game are really the only ones that cause me problems. Hello, friend! Are you ready to engage the boss? Oh, he wants to toast. Hang on. Yeah. Friendship, yeah. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and piss this thing off so you guys can come in. Woo-wee! Should be pretty pissed now. But, it's not really responding to us yet, so maybe it'll take a second. There we go! Now it's pissed. Alright, so this boss, like I said, pretty simple. He loves to help you kill his friends, which is interesting. But his weak spot is his balls. As long as you cut his balls, he goes down without much of an issue. Unless you let him sit on you. I guess that probably hurts, maybe. Eh. But God, he's so weird. This boss is just so freaking odd looking. No, don't sit on me. Ah! And we fall down in this place, which should look really familiar. We were here not 30 minutes ago. We broke his balls! Oh no! Where's his balls? Oh. They're on the front of him now, right. Forgot about that. Weirdo arm thing. Fuck you, weirdo arm thing. Fuck you. Yay! We got the thing. Happiness. Bye. Bye, friends. That was fun. See you all later. Alright, let's light this bonfire and head back to Firelink Shrine. I forgot to open that other door. Damn it. So one thing I didn't do was open that door so I can get back here really easily if I wanted to. So, yeah, let's go back to Firelink Shrine for now. I didn't see chat, I'm sorry. Yeah, I glance over at chat and someone's telling me to open the door and I'm just like, ah, oh, damn it. I could just run back and open it really quick. It's really not that far away from the bonfire. Welcome, speak. Very well, then take no. Alright.
Farewell, Ashen.
Bye. Bye, lady. What do you want to do? Do you want to level me up again? Have I died enough times? No, I haven't. Okay.